Hello and welcome to Grok Trade. My name is Jerry Usher, graduate student of the Grok Mentoring Program, and today is Wednesday, March 16th, 2011. Taking a look here at the S&P 500 daily, and wow, what a drop. The bears have come out. You can see that we were in this mini-me downtrend. It looked like we were forming a bullish pennant at first and then a bull flag, but now we broke out of that yesterday. Yesterday we closed down below the trend line, the lower trend line. That was not a good sign. Today we opened up, gapped down, and just fell the rest of the day. Pretty impressive down day today. We've got some levels of support here from these previous, this base back here, and then we've got another one here when we were rising and we based out here. So we've got some levels here of support. And with the trim being so low today too, also there's a good chance of some opening up bullish tomorrow, but whether the day is going to end bullish or not, that's another story. We'll have to take a look again and keep track of that tomorrow. Now, we've got 2 days to make up here. First of all, this is our bull stock of the week, MIPS, and this daily chart here we're looking at. We are currently in a falling wedge. Falling wedges are bullish. We're under the 20 and the 50 day moving average, and we're waiting for a close above this green line. Yesterday we gapped down only to come right back up into the triangle. Looked bullish, but however today with so much bearish pressure in the markets here, we're just still hanging out in this triangle. Now stocks hate to get pinched. We're getting close to the apex of the triangle. Something's going to happen sooner or later. It's more probable it'll break out than it is to break down, but we're looking for a close above this area here. So we've got quite a ways there. Keep your eye on MIPS. Our bear stock of this week is still ICLR. We're looking at a daily here, and let me move that over so you can see it. We were in a low base, gap down low base, and then we started pulling back here. So we had a bear pullback, and I actually had an entry down underneath this candlestick right here. You can see 2 days ago I was filled on the 14th, and felt a little heat there because we had almost an equal high yesterday. Lower high and a lower low. So we did have a bear day, even though it was a bullish candlestick, and we were closing right at the 20-day moving average there. Today, even with the big bear day in the markets, you can see if I blow that up real big here, let's see, we've got, again, very, very close, but slightly lower high, definitely a lower low. So the bears are still in control. We have a nice bearish candle here, looking for some follow through here, and a stop of course would be up in this area. So actually I haven't moved my stop down at all yet. I didn't feel like I had enough wiggle room. This guy seems very volatile. You know, big highs, big lows, big candlestick wicks here. I'd like to see these shadows get a little shorter and some follow through to the downside there. So we're going to keep our eye on that one. Now, if you are not in any bearish stocks yet, it's probably too late. I would definitely say it's not a good idea to get in now. We're extended to the downside, so it would be best to wait for either a low base here, a little area consolidation, or a slight pullback, and then to see if we can form a lower swing high. Lower swing high would be the best here, potentially here, to set up more bearish trades. Right now it's real hard being a bull. So there you go. We hope you're having a great week trading so far, and we'll be talking to you again soon. So take care, everybody.